thing depends on what happens here in the Kommandantur. Well, thank you, Dick. You've put your arguments very clearly. But you don't agree with this, Pat?
No, sir, I'm sorry, I can't agree. We've been over this scheme time and time again. It's just not on.
But why not? It's perfectly sound. We've checked and rechecked. From here to the pit, it's one of the best schemes we've ever had.
Well, that's my whole point. As far as the pit is no damn good, what happens after that?
Well, there must be some way out of the pit.
Why? Why must there be some way? We can't possibly know that, and I think it's irresponsible to just assume it.
Look, Pat, we need an escape. I understand there's a lot of value in planning and preparing, but morale is slipping. Two successful British escapes in 2 years is not exactly something to crow about.
Do I take it that this is a show of no confidence in myself as an escape
officer? No, steady on, Pat. I don't think anybody would mean to imply that.
Pat, you've done a marvelous job. It's just that I think it's worth a try. If it came off, it would give the whole place a real lift.
He's right, Pat.
I'm sorry, I can't agree to it.
Let me appeal to you, Sam. We feel very strongly about this. We're asking you to overrule Pat and let us go ahead.
I'm sorry, gentlemen. I will not overrule the escape officer. I appreciate a lot of your arguments and how strongly you feel about this. But I do agree with Pat that it is just not thorough enough. I'm sorry.
Sir.
Oh, Pat, hold on, will you? I'd like to have a word with you.
This dormitory is a disgrace. Soon it will not be possible to move about in here. What is that? A cricket bat. Even the English, I believe, don't play cricket in the winter. Okay. Who sleeps here?
I do.
This is not a boudoir, Lieutenant.
What, is the war over?
No, Lieutenant Player, the war is not over, but slovenly behavior is. I want all this unwanted material removed.
It's not unwanted. It's merely out of season.
We don't have very much, but what we do have, we need.
Nevertheless, it cannot remain here.
This is everything. All of it.
Good. I will have some tea chests sent over from the Kommandantur. You pack everything in there, and we'll store them in the attics.
Oh, no, those attics upstairs are damp. The roof leaks. And they're not locked. Our stuff will be knocked off in 10 minutes.
That's why it's in here.
They cannot remain here.
Hoppen. We'd appreciate it very much if we could put those things someplace where it's safe and dry.
It'd be somewhere in this castle where things won't get pinched.
As you are so concerned, we'll store them in the attics of the Kommandantur where no one will get at them.
But that's the German quarters.
Yeah, your men can steal those things, take them down in the village and sell them. They do it all the time, you know that.
That's enough. They will not be stolen from our quarters. The tea chests will be sent immediately. You have 1 hour to pack them.
All right. You all drink tea. How big is a tea chest?
That's so big. What?
We have 1 hour to get a man in a tea chest and get him out of here.
Well, how do you know there's a way out?
If you can get in, you can get out.
Those attics open right up on the outside.
What opens up right on the outside?
Listen, Phil's having a brainstorm, but I think it might work. Ullman's sending over some tea chests to store our spare gear. He's going to store them in the Kommandantur attics.
We put one man in one chest. When he gets clear, he gets out. It's that simple.
Just like that.
Yeah.
But we here are about half the escape committee. We have sweated over plans and schemes. Thorough, worked out, detailed and studied, and we've turned them down, all of us. And you jump into some half-baked idea that isn't even a thumbnail sketch.
Look, Pat, what has got into you?
Pat!
What is the matter with you?
It's a chance on a plate. Why not take it? It's better than sitting around here and doing nothing.
Yeah, and somebody gets a month in solitary or a bullet in his back because we haven't done our job properly.
Yeah, well, I'm tired of doing a good job for no purpose. For once!
Let's take a crazy idea and chance it. What's the matter with you? Don't you want to get out of here anymore?
That's not fair.
What do you mean, not fair?
I say we take a chance on it.
Let's try it. Anything! What do you say?
Right.
Still leaves the big question. Who?
I don't know whosever turn it is.
Well, Peter here.
Peter? He'd never get in the tea chest. He's bigger than I am.
Oh, we could try. It doesn't make any difference how big it is or whose turn it is. Just let's get going. Make some progress.
Get some sheets.
Come in. Hello, Pat.
I would like you to relieve me of my duties as escape officer, sir.
Just like that.
Just like that.
Why?
I think I've outlived my usefulness, sir.
I don't agree.
Well, perhaps I'm just becoming obstructive.
Now, look, Pat, you have taken the burden of these men as your own, and in so doing, relieve me of a lot of responsibility. They know it, I know it. We've a lot to thank you for.
I've had enough, sir.
All right, I suppose you really need a break. I'll agree to your standing down the moment I can find a replacement. Until then, you will remain as escape officer. Is that understood?
In line.
You are, Phil.
Well, I'll never get in there. I'm the same size as he is.
Well, you can have a try. Go on.
Come on, it's easy. You just fold your legs underneath. Come on, get it.
Yeah, well, show me that.
Listen, just take one leg like that. Put your other foot there. Come down like this.
Put your head, see?
Put your hand there. You put your head down like that, and you're in.
You're in.
Come on, get it.
You're going.
Wait a minute, it's not my turn.
Doesn't make any difference whose turn it is. You fit. You're going. Now, come on, get up.
No, let's pack up these other cases and make them really heavy.
Sir, you wanted to see me.
Yes. I understand that General von Kirst, the area commander, will arrive to inspect the entire castle in an hour's time. Can I assure him that everything is in order, Hauptmann?
Oh, yes, sir. I will arrange for an additional guard detail to be in evidence. Do you want me to call Appel when he arrives?
No, I don't think so. This is supposed to be an informal visit. Let's keep it so.
Very well, sir.
Ullman.
Okay, Simon, this is it.
Good luck.
You'll be sure that these things are safe and dry, right, Ullman?
Hauptmann Ullman to you, Lieutenant. You may rest assured they'll be perfectly safe and well stored. Einheim, nail down the lid.
I told you so, but by God, I feel like it.
All right, Pat. You were right, and I was wrong. The problem is, what are we going to do about Simon?
Well, look, we've got to give him a chance. I mean, for heaven's sake, it's not that hard to push out a few nails.
Can't have much air, Pat.
Do you think I don't realize that?
Well, from my experience in submarines, I reckon he has about an hour before he suffocates.
Right. I give him 50 minutes, and then I'm going to Ullman.
Achtung!
Ja, prima, prima.
Bloody well is possible.
Sie in die Richtung da.
looking for.
Da hat der Hund die Spur. Los!
Any news of Simon, sir?
Yes, there is. William Goodall. Carter is in sick bay with nothing worse than a broken ankle, for which he can thank his lucky stars. From there, he'll go to solitary. It was a damned stupid, harebrained attempt, which goes against everything we've tried to do in here. However, he has managed to pass some very valuable information to the doc here. That was before the German quack took over. I'll leave him to tell you about it.
Well, I gather it's information relating to what he called the pit escape. He said you'd understand. Anyway, this is it. You should use the door into the Kommandantur next to the main gate. There are no guards inside.
Is he quite sure about that?
Yes, absolutely sure. And his rope was too short. That's how he broke his ankle. And there's a guard patrols the top edge of the moat. And, well, that's it, I'm afraid. He obviously wanted to say more, but the German medical officer and Ullmann arrived and made it impossible.
All right, Doc. Thanks very much.
Right.
Now, in the light of this new information, and on the assumption that somehow we can get the rest of it from Carter, I'm giving the go-ahead on Dick's plan. However, I am going to make some stipulations. Firstly, it must be thoroughly planned. And secondly, every safeguard must be made to protect that route. If it works, we use it again. I leave that up to you, Pat, all right?
Right, sir.
Now, thirdly, I want this to be an escape not of one pair, but of two. Now, Dick, it was basically your plan, so naturally you'll have pride of place. Carter's out of it, so who are you going to take with you?
Peter.
Right. Now, lastly, I want Captain Grant to go as one of the other pair. Now, Pat will be relieved of his duties as escape officer only on the day of escape. Is that understood by everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Right, I'll leave you to it.
Who are you going to take, Pat?
Hmm? Oh. Phil. Right, let's get on with it. George, I want you to make a model of the entire escape route with no significant detail omitted. I want that by tomorrow night, right? Dick, go and find Sniffy Harris. Tell him I want the documents ready, stamped and valid for the four of us.
Right.
Tim, I want you to get cracking on the civvy rigging gear. Tonight, we go over the entire route in detail. Well, go on, there's no time to waste. Phil, come with me.
Here are your Ausweis. They're valid for 3 months from today.
Phil? Ausweis.
Hey, Sniffy, that's very good.
Good. As the committee agreed, you're Flemish concrete workers. Not many people speak Flemish, so you should get away with murder. Our latest info makes it quite legitimate for you to be traveling near the Swiss border. You'll be going to a site in Rottweil, where there are foreign workers. This is your fiancée, Gabrielle Lecoeur. Rather pretty, I thought.
Yeah, not bad.
Yeah, she's very nice.
I don't have a fiancé?
No fiancé for you. A letter from her. One of the French chaps wrote it.
Uh-huh.
A cutting from a local paper showing her working for Jerry. It isn't her, of course, but it's a reasonable likeness. Nice touch, though.
Ullman.
What's the matter?
I've got a pain.
Go and see the doctor.
Yes, yes.
Oh. Go to the sick room, I said. And I'm. Nimm den zum Arzt. What is this?
Glider.
We've decided, so that once we're out, we split up and try two quite separate routes. And the other two have decided on Chemnitz, Nuremberg. Phil and I prefer Zwickau, Munich. Phil's got an inbuilt aversion to Nuremberg. I think he covered too many party rallies there before the war.
Yeah, well, apart from that, do you think there are any advantages to your route?
Well, our way, we think there's slightly less chance of being picked up, but the other two can catch a train before morning appel, so it's swings and roundabouts. Mm.
What about getting out of here?
Under control, sir.
You know, Pat, for everyone's sake, this must work.
I realize that, sir. It will.
Here we are. It's the best I could do in the time, but it is accurate. Now, here's the prisoners' courtyard, our courtyard. You'll have to imagine the other buildings round here. I didn't have enough materials. The British quarters, we're in here. Here's the delousing shed. Here's the kitchen window with the pane that Dick broke. Over here is the German courtyard, the Kommandantur buildings. That's where Simon was taken in the tea chest. Over there is the moat and Switzerland.
Right, now let's go over the route. And for God's sake, get it firmly into your head. We need to be able to do this in our sleep. Right, now one by one, we cross from this corner made by the delousing shed through that kitchen window. Now, I should be able to put my hand through and drop the handle, but without your broken pane, Dick, we'd have to think again.
And what about the courtyard sentry?
Well, I've checked him till I'm sick of the sight of him. He's always there, exactly the same place, exactly the same routine. Phil's been checking once again. What do you make it, Phil?
17 paces, 17 seconds. He never varies, the same thing all the time.
Tell him what you've got. December 1940, 12 paces to turn. January 41, 16 paces to turn. August 41, 17 paces to turn. Thank God for German efficiency. They do everything by numbers.
Bit of a bore for their wives, eh, Dick?
All right, now, once we're all through that kitchen window, we cross to the rear window, here. Now, we know that it's glazed on the inside and has bars on the outside. Now, I'm going to get in and do something about the bars. Once we've got through that window, we drop onto this roof here. Now, there is a sentry in this courtyard that we've got to check. We can see him from Colonel Preston's window. I've arranged for you to do that tomorrow, Phil.
What do we know about him?
Well, so far, very little, except that he's rather erratic, possibly because this ground here is rather uneven. But that's why we need an audible cue for when he turns his back.
So that's where we need the band?
Right.
And they'll have to practice in the Colonel's quarters so that they can see the guard.
Mm-hmm.
He's not going to like that very much.
Well, I know it's hardly the Albert Hall, but I think he'll do it. This escape means rather a lot to him.
Pat, what happens when we get on top of this shed right here?
Well, I'm not going to answer that till I've been up there myself and had a thorough look.
You see him all right from there, Phil?
Yes, I can, Colonel. Thank you.
Good.
We desperately need the rest of Simon's information, sir.
Well, what are you going to do about that?
Well, I'm going to try to smuggle a message to him with his food. You see, we just don't know how many guards there are outside the Kommandantur. or exactly what this wire perimeter involves. We need specific information about the attic and the guard at the main gate. We just can't wait for Simon to get out of solitary in case Ullman finds that broken pane. We need that information now. There's one other thing, sir. We need an audible cue for when this guard outside here turns. Now, since this is the only place we can see him from, I wanted your permission to hold a band practice in here, sir, with one of the chaps watching through the window. I'm afraid it's going to be a bit noisy.
Yes, I expect it is. Well, that's all right, but I'd better hang around here in case anything goes wrong, and I'll give the signals, dear.
All right, sir.
How's it going, Phil?
Well, it's very erratic, you know. 8, 10, 12 paces sometimes. It's never the same. Take a look.
What do you think of the shrubbery?
Well, we won't have much cover with the first group of shrubs, but I think we can get to the second group without it getting too overcrowded.
We're really going to need that van signal, sir.
Jimmy, what do you think, Pat?
That's fine.
But what happens when there's a natural break in the music?
Just can't have it, Jimmy. Keep it going at all costs.
Yes, but surely...
Sentry coming up.
Right, let's have a few goes for practice. Good work, Jimmy. That's how we want it on the night.
Well, I think I've got everything you asked for, Pat. And I've also added one or two bits and pieces from our stores, if that's all right by you.
That's fine.
Now, Dick.
These flannel bags are still a trifle wet.
So, if you'll be in charge of getting them dry enough.
Yeah, of course. What do you dye them with?
Black boot polish diluted with the post sergeant's ready.
It's kind of separated, isn't it?
Oh, I rather like them, though.
Yeah, sort of a tweed effect.
Yeah, thanks.
Right, now, about those shirts. I managed to get the collar sizes bleached out of all of them except your blue one, Phil. So I've had to change that. Now, these matches and cigarettes are both Belgian origin, and they're two compasses. First one's the standard button type. Yeah? And the other one is hidden in the box of matches underneath the matches there. There's one French paperback, and you'll be given your rations and your German money just before you go. Well, I think that's just about it, Pat.
Now, what about the sheet rope? We need that extra length.
That's been lengthened to your specification.
Have you had a chance to test it yet?
Yes, but I think I must warn you that that bed ticking is rather perished. We just don't know whether it's going to hold up under the strain.
Well, we'll just have to chance that. There's no alternative. Now, there's one other thing. I've had four suitcases made.
Suitcases? Mm-hmm. What the hell for, Pat?
Look, people travelling in wartime are going somewhere. How many people do you see getting onto mainline trains without luggage? Only railway officials and escaping POWs.
That means we're going to have to lug suitcases all over Germany.
I know that, but we're not going without them.
Your presence is not required, Doctor. I've sent for the Stabsarzt.
I can't agree with you, Hartmann. Man has a fever, that's why I insist on coming. I'm responsible for the prisoners, it could be serious.
It is not serious.
But he has a fever. Under normal circumstances, with a normal diet, it wouldn't occur, but these men have no resistance.
I came as soon as I could, Hartmann. Is it serious, Doctor?
Mild fever, I think. Possibly due to tight plaster casing.
I'll give him a morphine injection.
Sie sich rein. Sie sollten schon seit 2 Minuten drin sein. Stubenzeit.
Groß, bist mächtig, sind stur wie die Panzer.
I got the rivet head sawn off. The snag is, I can't push the bloody thing out. The searchlights came on, there was no time.
This note came from Simon via the dock. Read that. Get the model. Watch the door from the outside.
Why can't you get the rivet out?
It's rusted into the vertical bar.
Well, what you need is some sort of thumbscrew punch to force it out.
Possibly.
Can you give me a drawing of the bars and the rivet?
Yes, I could do that.
All right, I'll work on it.
Fine.
See this?
Here they come. Good. Good. Right, now with this extra information, we're home and dry. Now, assuming that we can get through that window, we drop onto this roof here and behind this ventilation chimney thing, which should give us cover. We'll need it. It's brighter than daylight out there. And we drop into the courtyard and wait for the music signal. Now, they can see the sentry from Colonel Preston's window. Once we've had that music signal, we cross to the shrubs on the far side.
And what about the sentry?
He's so damned unpredictable, isn't he, Phil?
8, 10, 12 paces, never the same.
Now, that's why we must rely on that music signal. We just have to play that one by ear. Right, now we cross the Commandantur yard and into the pit on the far side. So far, Dick's old plan. Yeah. Now, we come to Simon's pit. Now, I cross from the pit to this door in the Commandantur building. There's one guard outside the main gate, but he's out of vision of that door.
The problem with Simon's information, though, is that this sentry here, when he turns, can see you.
Yes, there. In daylight, yes, but in darkness and with the shadows along here, we should be all right. And once we're through that door, we've got no problem. There are no guards inside. We go up the staircase and into the attic room where they're storing our stuff, and then through to the back of that room here. And that's where we need the extra length of rope.
And the guard on the moat?
Well, he patrols every 18 minutes.
18 minutes is not going to give us much time.
No, there's another snag. He's got a dog. Now, according to Simon, there are 3 tiers and not 2. There's one we can't see from the exercise park. The tiers have got ledges 20 inches wide.
20 inches in the dark.
Well, that's it, I'm afraid.
3 tiers, it's about a 30-foot drop.
Well, in fact, it's 46 feet. Is that rope going to be long enough?
Well, only just. Well, that just leaves you with the barbed wire, the German barracks, and the 12-foot outer wall.
Yeah, piece of cake.
Well, at least there's no perimeter guard. Now, there's one other thing. If all goes well, someone should be able to use this route again. So I propose taking an extra man as far as the kitchen window to tidy up and bring back our uniforms.
Who?
George. He knows the drill.
Raz, dwa, trzy, cztery. I raz, dwa, trzy, cztery. I raz, dwa, trzy, cztery. I raz, dwa, trzy, cztery. Raz, dwa, trzy, cztery. Raz, dwa, trzy, cztery. I raz, dwa, raz, dwa, raz, dwa, raz, dwa. I szybciej, szybciej. Raz, dwa, raz, dwa, raz, dwa, raz, dwa, raz, dwa. I dość. Trzymaj ramiona, trzymaj, trzymaj, w bok, nie opuszczaj. I ramiona skrzyżuj dołem. I będą cztery koła na zewnątrz, cztery do wewnątrz. Pamiętać, głową nie kiwać, w brzuch ciągnij. Uwaga, zaczynamy. Ćwicz. I raz, i dwa, i trzy, i cztery. I raz, i dwa, i trzy, i cztery.
He doesn't think about that broken window was sunk.
Wolniej, prosto, stój prosto. Dość! Klimowski Szydło, ile razy wam powtarzam, żebym nie wiedział, że jesteś...
Hopman Ullman, may I talk to you?
Łajzy! Kto trzeci się śmieje? Ścibor, tak? Koleżka Ścibor, zawsze trzeci się znajdzie.
It's about, Lieutenant Carter.
What about him?
Well, I thought that maybe under the circumstances you could get him transferred to sickbay.
Flight Lieutenant Carter was involved in a stupid escape attempt. That's why he's in solitary confinement. His physical condition has none of my concern. You know that.
Well, I thought maybe you could use your influence.
I'm afraid it's out of the question.
Postawa, ramiona w przód, lewa ręka w bok. Ćwiczenia trudne na koordynację. Uwaga, zaczynamy. I ćwicz. I raz, i dwa. I raz, i dwa. I raz, i dwa. I raz, i dwa.
I don't think I should be the one to do the cleaning up job. Why not? You're the only one who knows the full plan. It has to be. I want to, but... Well, you know what happened before? I lost my nerve. I'll let you down a bit. No, you won't. Everyone loses their nerve sometime. You had your moment. It won't happen again. Just forget about it.
Thank you.
All right, gentlemen. Will someone get out the crystal goblets? We're going to have a celebration.
Does this mean it's tonight?
Yes.
It was always tonight. I just didn't say so.
You mean you didn't trust us?
I wouldn't be going with you if I didn't trust you. You know. I just didn't want anyone, not even us, to make a slip, that's all.
But everything isn't ready.
Everything is ready.
Right. Down in one. Your health, gentlemen. Phil, good luck.
Thank you, sir.
Dick.
Goodbye, sir.
Peter.
Sir. Well,
goodbye, Pat.
Bye, sir.
Good luck, and it's been a privilege serving with you.
Good night.